So in the last video, we stood still by the distinction between tables and and graphs. Now, in this session, we're going to focus on the design of tables and actually on the structural design of tables. And there are only three types of tables, so let's have a look at them. The first one is the most simple one. It's what is called a unidirectional table, actually meaning it's only one dimension. We have a salesperson and we have revenue and they're just displayed in two separate columns. Now we can make that a little bit more complicated because it could be that we have more than one category. So next to salesperson we have also country. And then we can organize the different categories in some kind of hierarchy. So now we see the salesperson, and within the salesperson we see the different countries, and we see it's the revenue he or she created there. So that's still a unidirectional table. It's still one dimension. It's all organized in the rows, but now we have some kind of hierarchy of the different categories. But we could also create some kind of a two-dimensional table. It's called a cross table or a bidirectional table. We have the same categories. We have still salesperson and we have countries, but now we have put the countries in the columns. And we get a more compact display of our data set. So that are the three types of tables. We have unidirectional with one category. We have unidirectional with several categories, but organized somehow in a hierarchy. And we have a bidirectional table where we have categories across the rows and across the columns. So what about derived values? Let's have a look at this table. What we see is we see the different products and we see the units we have sold. And we see the revenue that was generated by these products. And we also have some kind of forecast. And then we have two columns that are actually calculations of the earlier columns. So we have a percentage of total, and in this case it's the percentage of total of the actual revenue. And we have as a percentage of forecast, which is actually the actual revenue as a percentage of the forecast. Now, you already can see that the way I have to explain it, this is not really clear. So we shouldn't do this. If you have derived values, if you have values that are calculated based on other columns, we should move these calculations as close to the other columns as possible. And now you see we have moved the percentage of total and put it next to the actual revenue. And now it's very clear that the percentage of total is a percentage of the actual revenue. And the same is true for the forecast. So that's about derived values. Now, what if you want to compare? Here we see again the same data, but now we want to have a difference between the forecast versus the revenue, and the forecast via the versus the planned revenue. If that's the case, it's important to have the columns that we have to compare, that we locate them as close as possible to the column to compare with. White space. Now, if you open your Excel spreadsheet and if you create your data, Excel will by definition give you a default row height, and that determines the amount of white space you see. And maybe you're wondering why is white space important, but white space helps us to determine what is a row and what is the next row and to distinct two rows from each other. And the more white space I give, the easier it is. But of course there is a balance, and here you see different values for the white space, and it's up to you to determine what you think is best readable. My preferation is either the 50 or the 100%. But it's important that you know that you have a choice yourself, that you can help the reader by defining the amount of white space, how he or she can interpret the table. And we can do that for rows, but of course we also can do that for the columns. And that actually goes back to what we said in the very first session, is that it's all about the message. What do I want to tell? What do I want to give to people? How do I want them to read my table? Should they read it by column by column? Then this would be a very good choice. Or would it be better if they read it row by row? And what I could do then is decrease the amount of white space between the columns and increase the white space between the rows. And then people automatically are going to read the table row by row and not column by column. So In this video, we saw a little bit about how to design the structure of a table. In the next session, we're going to look at some best practices that will help us to create really awesome tables.